Today, I'm on a mission here, okay? Huge mission. I'm gonna get at least 4 reps with 120 on each side. 4 reps, count them, 4, okay? I have a decent amount of marshmallows on each side. Okay, I got one marshmallow here, another one, and some partial marshmallows on the side. Now, the reason why I wanna do, actually I wanna do 5 reps. Not 4, 5. I miscounted. The reason why I want to do 5 is because last time when I had this exact amount of weight, I did a max of 4 reps. Now I want to improve my numbers by doing at least 1 more rep. If I could do more than that, that's amazing. I'm going to strive to do more than that, but I at least want to do 1 more rep than last time. For the first like 2 or 3 reps, I think I got For the first 3 sets with 120, I did 3 reps. For the last set, I did 4. So as long as I beat the numbers from last time, I'm happy. So I gotta do 4, 4, 4, then 5, or at least 5, 4, 4, 4, 4, okay? That's all I care about. Well, there you go. More than 4 reps. I did 6, failed trying to do 7, which is exactly what I need. Now I hope the next 3 sets are just like that one. But that's a huge milestone. Honestly, I didn't think I was going to do more than 5. That was not the plan. But hey, I'm going to take the win. And I'm going to give credit where credit's due, because my girlfriend, she made this delicious steak earlier. Like, literally, I just ate it like 30 minutes ago. Steak, chicken salad, and some sweet potatoes. It was fucking delicious. So, like, I am, like, carved up. I'm proteined up. Like, I'm not overly full. I am satisfied, which is awesome. And I accidentally took some of her pre-workout, which has some caffeine in it. Now I'm sipping through this. I'm not chugging it. Just cause I don't want to chug it. I know it's not actual pre-workout. It's just some aminos with some caffeine in it, which is definitely gonna help out in the long run. Man, I'm ready to go. Like, I want to add more weight on here, but I can't. Not until I do 8 reps or at least 2 or 3 sets back to back. Here we go, set number 2. It has been 4 minutes, so I should be well enough and rested to do another minimum 5 reps.
Let's go, one. One more.
I'm a little lightheaded, but that's okay. It's all right. It happens sometimes, but actually, the last time this happened, I ended up going to the ER. But that was for an entirely different reason of being lightheaded. I would be passed out donating blood. Like I say all the time, you just gotta make sure you track your workout so that way you know that you're making progress. Next, I come in here and do this. My goal is to beat the 5 reps that I just did. Or honestly, beat 6 reps, because for the first set, I did 6 reps. All right, I got 2 more sets to go, and then I can finally move on. I'm doing the whole thing of, 12 total working sets. So I'm only 2 sets in. I got 10 more sets to go. So 4 here, maybe 4 in the next one. Don't know if I'm going to be doing the pec deck, but I'll do 3 or 4 sets there if I decide to do it. And then I believe I'll do the dumbbell bench press. Really finish off my chest. You know, maybe I'll do some cable flies from like low cable flies to the high, to the top. I don't like the pulleys here, so I don't know if I'll end up doing those. But maybe I'll give it a try, because it's been a while since I've done those. And even if it's on lightweight, it's some extra stimulus for sure. But we'll see what happens. Oh, my head. Oh, my head. Oh, fuck. I don't know why, but my head. Oh, my God, just started hurting. Oh, man. My right side right here. Just, oh, it's fucking killing me. Like, it's slowly getting worse. So hopefully I can make it through this workout without just saying, fuck it, I can't do anything because my head just, it's just pounding without its blood rushing to my head. Okay, one more set. All right, do at least 5 reps. I really want to say 4 because I think I'm going to quit by 4 reps, but I had to do 5. I need to.
Fuck.
Oh, fuck my head. Oh. Oh my God. I'm not gonna lie, I had that one, but. Oh. I don't know why, it's just the right hemisphere of my brain. I don't like this. But at least overall, I did better than the time before. So, I mean, that's an improvement. So, I'm moving on.
All right, shout out to the guy working the front desk because he luckily had some ibuprofen, which I don't believe I'm allowed to have, to be honest, because I am taking on the Eliquis, which in 4 days, I'm done taking the Eliquis, which is going to be great. Something I don't have to worry about taking anymore. So I don't think it's going to be that big of a deal if I take the ibuprofen when I'm not supposed to. I might have to take it easy for this exercise just because, like, I don't know what happened, but it's just, I don't feel okay anymore. All right, so the heaviest I can go here is 170 for 5 reps. Let's do, I don't know, like 100 for like a few reps or a few sets, I mean. And see if my headache goes away. I really hope it does. I just did 2 like warm-up sets with 100 pounds, and then after like 2 reps, my head just starts to throb. It is fucking killing me. Oh, okay, surprisingly, my head's not hurting right now. Okay, maybe the ibuprofen is finally kicking in. I hope so. I'm gonna get a few more minutes before I do like a heavy set, because there's no way that a heavy set's gonna be possible with this headache. All right, one last easy warm-up set. Did I go heavier? I did go heavier. This is 120, so it's 20 pounds heavier. Oh. I really don't want to call it a day, but fuck this headache, man. All right, hopefully this set's better than the last ones. Because if it's not, then I might just have to skip it and do some cardio for a bit. Oh, fuck. Nope. Yep, I'm done. I'm fucking done. Fuck today. I'm fucking... Oh, fuck me. God, fuck. I don't know what the fuck I did. Alright. I guess I just walked on the treadmill for like 15 minutes or so. I guess I didn't fuck around enough. Then, if it's gone, I'll do the dumbbell. I really hope this fucking headache goes away because I'm not enjoying it whatsoever. I don't know what caused it. I don't know where this came from. Like, I ate before this, so there's no reason my head should be hurting. I've had my liquid IV. I didn't do much cardio today. Like, I got my 10,000 steps. I didn't do anything beyond that. But here I am. I guess maybe I just need to get more steps in. I don't know. And I've had drops of some water, had coffee, I had my girlfriend's aminos, which has more sodium, potassium, and whatever the third hydrating thing is, and which also has caffeine. I've had caffeine today, so like, out of the normal circumstances that my head hurts, none of those are it. Like I said, I ate before this too, so it can't be a hunger headache. But I don't think that this ibuprofen is going to kick in anytime soon, because, well, like I said, I just ate like 45 minutes ago. Now at this point, maybe an hour ago. But like, I ate a huge volume of food, so like, all that needs to digest enough for the ibuprofen to like really make way into my digestive tract or something, whatever it's called. I think they turned the heater on in here, and I don't like it. Like, it smells. It's probably just all the dirt, all the dust that's been accumulating in there from the last year. Just kind of burning out because of the heat. But I kind of wish that they would keep the AC on, because when there's a bunch of people in here, it gets fucking hot. And it gets really fucking annoying. Because, like, I'm, like, too hot, don't want to work out. But that's just like more of a me thing than anything. But maybe other people feel it as well. It's just like when it's too hot, like it's too humid. It'd be one thing if the windows were open and fresh air was coming in. But now, during the winter, this gym kind of sucks to be at, I'm not gonna lie. I really wish I still had my game controller for my phone so I could be playing Call of Duty right now while I'm walking. I returned the controller, because my thought was, maybe I'll buy the PlayStation portable thing and just do a hotspot. That way I can have a bigger screen. But didn't buy it.
Oh yeah. It's been about like 20 minutes since I did an exercise or something. So I'm just gonna see how 25s feel right now with my head. Well, this is too light. Let's see if these 60s are too heavy.
My head wasn't hurting this time like it was earlier, but it's definitely, I don't feel comfortable. I feel like I'm having a heat stroke or something. Like, I feel like it's too hot in this gym. I don't know what it is, but my head, man. I'm gonna do 75s. Fuck, man, I can't speak. I'm going to attempt to do 75s. I'm gonna try to withstand the pain, but 60s are, I mean, it's too light so far to really tell if it's gonna cause an issue. But man, that was a good set though. 60s. Oh yeah, let me make sure I mark that down so that way I know. Where's my phone at?
75 pounds. Attempt number one. Oh fuck. That's a bad setup. I think the ibuprofen kicked in. My head is hurting a little bit, but not to the same extent as it was earlier.
Yeah, I don't think I've ever done 8 reps with 75 pounds before. That's a huge milestone for me.
Yeah, no, the most I have on here is,
what? That's disappointing. I guess back in July, I did 9 reps with 75 pounds. Kind of disappointing, but I mean, it's been a while. what, it's been 4 months, 5 months since July, August, September, October, 3 months, 3-4 months since I last did this. So, I take that as a win, you know. It's still something new because I haven't done that in a while. I kind of want to go to the 80s. I'm going to give those a go. So there's 180 here. Where's another 80? There's another one over there. Fucking why not? I'll do the 80s to see how many reps I can do. Have I ever attempted 80s before? Have I ever? At least on this spreadsheet, it does not look like I've ever done 80s before. There's another spreadsheet from like a modified workout plan that I used to do. Very similar to this one, it's just a different. That has a lot more history on it, so it's possible that I have done 80s before. It's just because I have it, everything on different spreadsheets, I don't know if I have or not. You know, it's not gonna be easy for me to find, and I don't want to look for it. But if I had my workout app working, I would quickly be able to tell if that was the thing. I just need to figure out why the fuck the button isn't working. Can't figure it out, don't know why. It's pissing me off because I want to get the app working again on my phone. I just gotta keep messing around with it. Don't know exactly what I need to mess around with, but I might just have to redo the whole layout of this detailed page, which I could probably use a refresher, let's be honest. I mean, I don't think I've ever shown that before, but it's not the best UI. But I think this is a great opportunity for me to make it better visually and hopefully get it working again, you know? So maybe, actually I won't do this weekend. I'm going out to a wedding tomorrow night. Probably won't be back until Sunday morning. Then I have my nephew's birthday, which I'm excited for. And maybe Sunday afternoon I'll have some time, but it doesn't look like.
Let's go. Let's go. Oh. Let's go.
That was a good set, man. That was. I don't know how many reps I did. I want to say that was 5. I'll just look back at the video. Why not? Holy shit. That was a lot more reps than I thought. That was 7 reps. All right. I'm going to do that one more time. Because I'm having a pretty good chest day. And the ibuprofen definitely kicked in. My head wants to hurt, but like the pain receptors are just not there anymore. So I'm happy about that. I'm happy. Goddamn, 7 reps with 80 pounds. I don't think I've ever done that before, ever in my life. So that's a good sign that I'm getting stronger. And that's definitely a new baseline, 80 pounds. You know, it sucks as my chest development isn't there to really show that I can lift 80 pounds. That part sucks, but we'll get there eventually.
Let's go.
Okay, that was a good set, man. Oh, that was rewarding. Today's workout was phenomenal, you know, and honestly, make sure you subscribe to the channel
so that we stay up with the winter arc, because the winter arc is not over yet. I got some bad news. I went up in weight, went from 208 to 212, almost 213. And honestly, last night, my girlfriend and I had a date night. We made some homemade pizza, protein pizza at that. And we're thinking this is going to be the best option. We won't go up in weight. And unfortunately, we went up in weight. We also had it pretty late. So that is a contributing factor as well. So like whatever we ate last night may not have left our bodies until later this morning, you know, after we weighed ourselves. So it is what it is. Tomorrow, I'm hoping that I wake up and I'm back down to 208. I might have a snack before I go and sleep. But tomorrow night, like I said, I'm going to this wedding. We're probably going to be drinking. Because it's not a wedding I want to go to. It's not. And the worst part about it is it's a cash bar. You know? I'm like, well, yeah. You know, yeah. So, like, I'm going to be spending money to go there. Spending money to get drinks that I don't think they're going to have some decent drinks either. So, the only reason that I probably will be drinking tomorrow night is just to get through the night, get it over with as quickly as possible. I don't want to be honest. I do not want to. But it's just like, I am afraid that I'm just going to be bored out of my mind. Yeah. I hate to say it. I hope I'm not. Hopefully I'm wrong. But like, I just think I will be. And, yeah, man. Hopefully Sunday, Sunday morning, I don't think I'm going to have an accurate weigh-in, just because whatever happened Saturday night, it's not going to be any good. Weigh-in Sunday, I'll weigh myself, but it won't be accurate. It won't be a good number. Like, and by a good number, I just mean, like, from whatever happens on Saturday night won't translate well to Sunday morning. Even if I don't drink and it's just like a casual night out, then it'll probably be a good number. But because whatever junk food we end up eating, whatever, you know, it is what it is. Do I want to eat just junk food? Yeah, every once in a while. Like, I've been fluctuating up and down. I really need to redial it back in 100%. But with... I believe I got to the point where it is very difficult for me to continue losing weight with my current trajectory, whatever, with what I've been doing, because my body's getting used to it. And so I guess I need to like find a common ground and kind of stay at my weight for a little bit longer of like, let's say 210, not going higher, not going lower. Well, maybe with like a 2-3 pound fluctuation, but like, obviously I'm not trying to go back to 220 and above. So staying around there for a little while, let my body can get used to just this weight, and then I can ramp back up and start going down in weight again. That's my idea. I do want to achieve 200 pounds. That is my next goal. Like, it's technically 205, but then from 205 it is 200. So I'm just trying to I'm trying to segment my things. I'm trying to partition my weigh-ins, you know. So 205, then 200, and then I'll reassess where I'm at, and then go from there, and try to maintain 200. But I think I need to maintain 210 for now. It sucks, but I think that's just where I need to be. Anyways, like I said, thanks for watching. Make sure you subscribe and check out the rest of the video that's playing right here to watch whatever happened in the next or the previous winter arc video.